love the unexplainable beauty, an excerpt from Beyond the Clouds. Love has no motive. Love simply is. It is the expression of inner harmony, oneness, and beauty. Love is absurd, meaningless, and purposeless, yet beyond all explanations and words too. Love is the only energy that remains unanswerable. This is the only question which cannot be answered, hence the beauty of it. Whenever you come across a question which is unanswerable, you are very close to God. Love is a mystery, not a problem. It can be lived but cannot be solved. In fact, it is not a question. That is why it cannot be answered. You can make a question of it. You can make a question out of it, but your question remains just a linguistic formulation of something which can never be reduced to a question. And that which cannot be reduced to a question remains unexplainable. Love is an unseen but realized truth. Love has no motive. Love simply is. Love is absurd, meaningless, and purposeless, yet beyond all explanations and words too. And that is why it is so beautiful. It is not a commodity, and also it is not a thing of the world. It is something from the beyond. It is a visitor from the beyond. So we cannot find any reason for it. If you can find any reason for your love, then it is not love, instead something else. If you can answer why, that will simply mean it was something else, not love. Love is the purpose of all. Hence, love itself cannot have any purpose. It is beyond all purposes. Love is the end of all. Everything else is a means towards love. Hence, love cannot be a means to something else. It is the ultimate value. But the question arises because the mind knows only how to create questions. It cannot accept that something can be a mystery. It cannot accept something which is a mystery. The mysterious creates fear in the mind, because the mind cannot manipulate the mysterious. Mind can manipulate only the known. The mind starts raising 1001 questions, and the mind will not feel at ease unless those questions are answered. Hence, the dilemma of love is there. If those questions are not answered, then mind has a tendency to deny the whole phenomena itself. Then the mind will say, if the why cannot be known, then love cannot be. If the why cannot be known, then love cannot be. Mind believes only if it is capable of manipulating something. That is why mind goes on denying God, because God is nothing but the very essence of love. very essence of the existence, and mind goes on denying love, and also mind goes on denying beauty and everything that comes as a mystery. Either the mind has to reduce it to knowledge, or if the mind feels impotent to reduce it to knowledge, it starts denying it. There is no God, there is no love, and there is no mystery. The mysterious is frightened, because the mysterious is vast like an unfathomable ocean, and the mind feels lost in the mysterious. That is why in all the languages the expression exists, falling in love. It is a condemnation from the mind. The mind is saying, you are falling, you are going lower than yourself, you are moving into something which is not true, because it cannot be formulated in a clear-cut concept. You are falling into something vague, something cloudy. You are becoming a chaos, avoided. This is the reason that we use the statement falling in love. Falling in love means entering into something which is vague, cloudy, and something that cannot be explained. Mind says, avoid love. And that is why in the world you find so little love, because the world is full of mind. We teach mind from the very childhood, from kindergarten to the university. We go on teaching and strengthening the mind, and we avoid heart. The entire education is cultured towards developing the mind and making heart subservient. We have learned the ways to bypass the heart completely, because heart is the door to the mysterious, where wise cannot be answered. In the realm of the heart, wise cannot be answered. Heart only knows how, not wise. And if a man has avoided the heart, he has avoided all the joys of life. His life is barren, insipid, without any taste. He has avoided his own innermost core, his anteriority. He has avoided his subjectivity. He has avoided the greatest experience that life makes possible, the experience of love. Drop the why. If you have fallen in love, go on falling more and more. There is no end to it, and you will reach to the very core of it. It is a bottomless abyss, and the more you fall, the more you become able to fall further. And the deeper you have gone into the abyss, the greater and greater the mysteries that become available to you. Then life is poetry, not a prose. Then life is not a noise, instead a melody, a harmony, a synergistic harmony. Then life is not matter, but God. But then slowly and slowly all whys and all the hows will disappear, and there will be pure empty space. You will live in the ishness of the moment. Your life will have a tremendous presence but no answers. You will know what life is, but you will not have any knowledge at all. Knowing is one thing and knowledge another. Love is a phenomena which can be experienced. Knowing is possible, but knowledge is not possible. It cannot be communicated in words. Love speaks through silent gestures and pronounces aesthetic beauties. It is unseen but realized truth. It remains such a deep taste in you that you cannot bring it to any verbal communication. Love simply happens. Love is a happening. If you do it, you can answer the why, but you are not the doer. You are just a host to something from the beyond. A guest comes from the beyond and knocks on your door. How can you answer why? You have never known him before, and even if you know now, it is so overwhelming that all words are inadequate to express it. Tears can say something, maybe, perhaps, or a dance, or a song, or a hug, but words are very inadequate. Words are meant to be for the mundane life of the marketplace. You cannot use them in love, and you cannot use them in prayer. Prayer, like love, is an expression of your oneness, and you cannot use them whenever and wherever the unknown is felt. When you come to the boundary of the known and the unknown, words start disappearing from you like the dead leaves falling from the tree, and a totally new experience evolves. This is wordless experience. You are asking the question because you must be feeling a little frightened. It is frightening because in love, you will not be in control anymore. It is frightening because in love, the ego will disappear. It is frightening because you will have to die. Love requires that much sacrifice. Love requires that much sacrifice. Die in love and you will be born as love. And you will never again be the same. And the world will be totally different. The same world will be so full of God if you are full of love. I teach love. Love is my message. But the way to teach it is not by talking about it. I exist here as love. And that becomes a catalytic agent. And something is triggered in you. And something starts growing in you. You become pregnant. You give birth to yourself. And when a woman for the first time becomes pregnant, she is very afraid. And she feels many pains, agonies and weight. And something so totally new is happening that she does not know where she is going and what is going to happen. A new life is being born. In love you become pregnant. A new spirit is being born, and in the beginning it is heavy. And in the beginning it is so new that you would like to escape from it. But never escape love, because love is the temple of God. When it happens, let it happen. Help it to happen. Even if you have to die and disappear into it, die and disappear. But accept the challenge. Rise to the challenge. And for the first time you will have something valuable in your life, something of the divine fragrance. But I cannot answer why you have fallen in love. I am in love with existence. I am in the state of love. Or you can say lovingness is my essence. It must have created some parallel phenomena in you. It must be something not like cause and effect, but what Carl Gustav Jung calls this, the law of synchronicity. When it creates a parallel port in you, it is the law of synchronicity. It is said that if in a small room you play on one sitar and another sitar is just in the other corner of the room, when you start playing on one sitar, the other will start resonating. The other starts responding. The other instrument starts responding, and this response is resonance. It will vibrate and its string will start dancing. You are playing on one sitar, the other is not even touched, but you are playing on the sitar and something has moved in the other one. It is not a cause and effect relationship. Instead, it is synchronicity. I am the essence of love. If you come close to me, something will start dancing in your heart. Allow it. Your society is against it. Your education is against it. And your life up to now, your society is against it. Your education is against it. And your very life up to now has been against it. It will be difficult to take the first steps. But those steps have to be taken. Otherwise, you will miss the glory of the existence, the splendor. Splendors are revealed only to lovers. A real disciple is in total love. Rather than asking why, take a jump into it. Be colored with my color. Become part of this growing awareness. Become part of this tidal wave, and it will be very easy for you to reach God. Alone it is difficult. When many are moving, it becomes easy because they support each other. This is a way where people can support each other on the way. The journey is arduous and long. And the goal is far away, and there is 1001 hazards on the way and pitfalls. And one can go astray any moment. And the higher you move, the more difficult it becomes. Even breathing becomes difficult. And the higher you move, the greater is the danger of. But if many are moving, they can hold each other's hand. They can support each other. You have fallen in love with me. Rather than asking why, go deeper into it. Know its depth. They will not answer your question, but they will dissolve your question. That experience will not become knowledgeable. That experience will not become knowledge, but that experience will make you. It will give birth to you. It will make you more innocent. Real experience always makes you more and more innocent rather than making you more knowledgeable and cunning. Problems are not solved. Problems are not solved here. Around the master problem and the questions, problems are not solved. Questions are not answered. Instead, they all dissolve in an unfathomable ocean of the energy, ocean of love. Only this much